Yo, what's up everybody? Welcome to a new episode of Let's Build Minecraft. Let's jump right in. We are in the snapshot, which means... Wait a minute. How do you dye beds? I thought you could dye beds. Does it take more than one dye? Take two. Okay, never mind. Okay, we are in the latest snapshot. And they added colored beds. Ooh, I'm surprised they even let me sleep with you right there. For those of you that haven't seen, that's my retextured zombies that look like orcs because this is an orc stronghold. I've done lots of work. I'll show you. Excuse me. We have dyeable beds now, or rather different colored beds that you just use different color wool. I thought that you could dye existing beds, though. Apparently you can't. They also gave them slime block properties for bouncing, and that's what I updated my version of Minecraft for. No, actually, I accidentally updated it and updated my world, and I didn't really mean to, because we were going to do it the other episode for parrots, but then I couldn't find parrots. Someone told me that I couldn't find any parrots because they changed it. So that they only spawned in newly explored jungles, which I'm pretty sure I've explored that entire jungle, or most of it that our jungle village is in. So I don't think we're gonna have any parrots there. But this is what I've done. Looky. This still working on. By the way, just a performance tip for everyone. I noticed that when it upgraded to this snapshot, it had changed. If you look in the top right, allocated memory, or memory, 4,000 megabytes, it had changed that down to 1,000, and that's why I was getting so much lag when I tried to update before. So, changing the allocated memory is a little different now. You actually have to go in and, Well, since they changed the launchers a little differently, but a quick search and you'll be doing fine. Actually, don't go anywhere near the building. Okay. I wasn't even that close. This is one of the things I did, and I'll tell you why. I want this path to not be covered. Now, we've solved this problem, and I've partially built a wall up here, but I'll show you. We've partially solved that problem up here because these are half slabs on a half block level, so snow can't land on them. Over here, though, every time that snowed, it was covering up this pathway. So I put a roof over it, and all in all, I think it was a good decision. We'll have to tie it in with the buildings in another way. I don't like it just the way it is, but I definitely do like it. Let me put back that, I like how it got rid of the item frame, but the torch lives on, and then, yeah. That's fine, I have a mirror copy over there, I think, mostly. Actually, I don't think anything blew up other than dirt and a log right there, and I'll just fill in that dirt hole later, I guess. What we're doing is going to be right here, by the way. I'll show you the rest of what I did. I don't remember what you've seen last time. I've almost entirely finished this building, and I don't think it was. And then this building I've been working on today, and the bottom half of it is not done yet, which is the part that's most detail-intensive. It takes the longest. So, you know... still off-camera work, because you've got... I'm not going to keep building these things on camera, but I've gotten, like, I don't know, a good 8 hours of work in since last episode, just working on this kind of stuff, working on the walls, working on all this. Phone, shut up. Yeah, so I'm pretty happy with it, and to be honest, we're getting fairly close to the end of this area. These three towers are the main parts of this build, so what we're going to focus on once they're all fleshed out, is buildings in between connecting the towers, which these walls are helping with that, and there'll have to be more to that. We'll have to finish this wall, which is, that's nothing. Nothing. Knock that out in my sleep. And then I want this area to be a lot less boring right here. And I think I want to maybe do some paths and some environment stuff a little bit. I don't really have anywhere for a path to go, because I'm definitely not hooking this up to our other towns, because this is like, this isn't like a friendly place. It was at one time, but it's taken over by orcs. So we definitely won't have roads connecting. And it's really long ways away. It's like 1,000 blocks that way. I'm not making a road that long. I'm just not happening. But right here is where we're going to be building. I'm going to get this. Ooh, don't need to do that. By the way, there's a few things broken in this snapshot. I sure hope that there's nothing that's world-breaking, because I did update my, like, my playable version without making a backup. But look, I'm clicking. I can't get rid of these. I can't, like, throw blocks away. It's actually pretty annoying. That's the only glitch I've found so far. Other than that, like, sometimes I'll be at, like, 100 frames, and then I'll just drop down, like, blah, down to, like 20. And it kind of sucks. Like, right there, just did it. I don't know if you're seeing it, though. I hope not. But we're going to take a page out of my own tutorials for this episode. I was thinking, like, you know, I've done quite a few tutorials on things that you can do just to spruce up an area when you don't know what to fill it with. And that's kind of what I was dealing with here. I didn't know entirely what I wanted to do with it. Well, it's cold. This is really what gave me the idea. There's like a lack of shelter out here, unless you are inside the building. You know, we have like this little overhang right here, but this is nothing. But I want a fire pit, and I want an overhang on it, so I'm going to get the materials for that, and then I'll see ya when I'm ready. I think most of you have probably seen this. I don't think anybody comes to my channel for Minecraft news, because I'm usually pretty far behind on the snapshots and stuff. But check this out. You watching? Bam! Look at that. That's game-changing on very little levels. Actually, it is pretty important, because glass now connects as well to the backside of stairs, which it didn't before. So you can do some things with windows that you couldn't before. For example, right here, I could make these. Ooh, let's try that. Do I have cobble on me? I wonder how this would look. Do I have dirt on me? Yes. Yes. Let's get on up there. This probably won't improve anything a whole lot, to be honest. Is it nighttime? Ugh. So if we knock these out, obviously these panes are going to turn into... Ooh, those panes are actually set back. Let's actually bring them forward. Good thing I have a silk touch pick on me. So our panes would normally be like that. But if we do this and this, it's getting dark. Let's step back, see how it looks. I should have put a torch behind it, see how that looked. Ooh. That gives it like a narrow window look. Let me look at it again once I wake up. I wish I could see it from this view. I gotta move this whole like setup I have here. It's just so in the way of the entrance of this place. So there's a space behind it where I need to fill in a block. I actually do really like that. Like, I didn't think that would make much of a difference, but I like that. Good change. Good change, Mojang. Fireplace. Yeah, that's what I was gonna do now. I'm not going to do one exactly the same as what I've done in my tutorial. Now, where do I want? I want to be able to walk around it without I don't want it to be too in the way. I don't think I want it to be set in the ground. I think I'm okay with knocking this wall back a little bit to make room. We can terraform this and make it all a little bit better. But let's just use this as a central point for now. That gives us plenty of room to walk over here the way I'm gonna set it up, I think. I got a new flint and steel, and huzzah. That's it. No, just kidding. Let's use half slabs for the pit actually building up around it. Where did I put that? Here it is. For the I want to see the flames like coming up over the blocks. So let's just get a few of these. We don't really need many. And just like this, I guess. Perfectly good. We're gonna have benches. I'm gonna put down the benches right now because I want to make sure. I might have to use stone benches, huh? I don't know exactly what the radius for fire is. If I put these here, though, will those catch on fire? I guess we'll find out. I'm actually thinking of making the ceiling or the roof above it fire. So we have to make it high enough so that it's not within range of any of those. Let's get some of these. Now we have a few options here. I'm gonna have like a chimney type object. Why did I do that? I'm gonna have like a chimney type object above it. Now if I do something like this, will it cover too much of it? I'm gonna say yes. It does cover quite a bit of it, but you know, if you're right here, I think it's still all right. The other alternative would be just walls like that. Let's actually knock those out. It's this little detail stuff that you can really get into. Oops. Nope, not like that. And spend a lot of time on like a single block. I think I actually liked it the way it was, even though it covers up a lot of the fire. So this is the idea is that this could be like a community, you know. Just a gathering spot. Am I blind? Cobblestone? A gathering spot, somewhere that you could cook if you wanted, I guess. I don't know. Do orcs cook? Like I said, this wasn't an orc spot to begin with. Now, how far up do I have to go? Could I use fence on the next block up? I don't think I could. I think you have to go 5 blocks away. But this is only 4 blocks away, so that's true then. This is going to start on fire soon. I'm not entirely sure. Let's get some dirt for pillaring. I don't need a shovel on me. Not at the moment. Oh, okay. We can do it like that. So we can get back up. Genius. I'm gonna need more cobblestone, though. So how are you guys? Oh, I just made all of my cobblestone into walls. I have to go get more walls. So yeah, like I talked about, we're getting close to the end of this project, which will make this the first project to actually get fully finished in this world, I believe. Yes, we actually have 3 towns that are not finished. The farming village is very close. One of them was like a warm-up to my YouTube experience. I don't know if that will ever get revisited. Maybe if people really want. Now I want to make some sort of smoke hood. So, like this. Yeah, I actually went back and revisited that area. For those of you that don't know, it was supposed to be a town inspired by River Riften from the Skyrim series. And I know where I went wrong with it. I know what I'd change if I were to go back to it. But it's like, I think I'd have to redo a lot of it. Like, I don't see a point in going back to it unless it'd be like restarting a whole new build. Not really that happy with it. It's amazing how I had not been playing Minecraft for a few years when I started back up with this series. I had always played way back, and then I decided to get back into it. And so it's going to be our chimney, and then our roof is going to sit on top of this. And we're going to make that out of these. So this will just give you a little bit of insight on the history of this channel in the making. What did I say that I needed? I needed these. I found a mega taiga not too far away, by the way, and I farmed a whole bunch of this so that I can stop using the trees outside as wood. I want to place this right now and just make doubly sure that that's not going to catch on fire. But yeah, I started building, and you know, I'd always been a builder kind of, and I'd always been horrible at redstone. If you're not into like PvP, which I'm not, and you're not into redstone, then yeah, you better be a good builder, or else you're probably not good at Minecraft. I mean, what's good at Minecraft is there's no like objective goal, but whatever. Anyways, it's funny looking back how bad those builds were. Like, I had the right idea going in, and I think I'd lost a lot of my touches, my personal touches, when I came back. Which is, you know, funny. It's like a muscle. You got to exercise it. So now I, you know, pick up new things. And even now, I think I go back and look at some of my old stuff and can pick up tricks that I haven't used for a while. I just want to make this a better circle. So this is just going to be a circle, a circular roof. And if you don't know how I make these, it's just... Okay, so that's our answer. We got to move this one more up. And our stairs are not going to burn, it looks like. So I'm just going to move this on one up. A little bit of a, like, mini channel update. I've been experimenting with editing styles and, you know, intros and outros. And because I tried out doing... And let me know what you prefer. Or maybe you don't care either way. I have to like appeal to the masses, unfortunately, with this YouTube thing. I'm not sure where I want. I don't think I want that there. I can barely reach. I was trying like a very production heavy style for a little while, and to be honest, I felt like it worked for me pretty well. Like, I was doing lots of montages. I was like finding a nice song to do each episode to. But then I've seen a lot of opinions where people say something. I've seen these mostly in jest, mostly jokes, where people make fun of, you know, the Minecraft community and how, like, you know, the stereotypical video that's like, hey, guys and girls, what's up? How are you doing? My name is this. And talk before I get to the video. Like, obviously, that's a big no-no that I try to avoid. but you know the stereotype. And with the, like, 10-second-long 3D intro, you know, I feel like I'm almost getting too close to that with the production that I had been doing. And you know, I've seen comments online where people say something like, if I don't hear you talk about what I came to the video for within the first 10 seconds, then I leave. And that's bad. That's not a good thing, obviously. But I, like I said, at the same time, I felt like I had been doing pretty well that period that I was experimenting with that style. Now I've been experimenting with a very concise style. Like, instead of 30 to 40 minute videos, I've been playing around with, do I have slabs still? I do have a few more, but let's make even more. I've been playing around with like 15 to 20 minute videos. And now I hear a lot of people say that the sweet spot, I'm just watching this, make sure that none of this goes up in flames. The sweet spot, if there is one. Hello? That's not right. Hello? The sweet spot's between 20 and 25. Because most people don't want to commit a whole half hour to an episode. And it's hard to judge for myself because usually, or I watch very few Minecraft or just YouTube videos in general. And when I do watch them, it's from like a select few guys that I watch, and I want them to be long because, you know, it's all that I watch, and then I'll be done with YouTube for the day. But I know that my view isn't necessarily what everyone wants. So let me know what you've been enjoying. If it's, you know, me getting in and out with a build and showing you what I can do, or do you like the production style and the, you know, a bit of a glamour touch, you know, to hide the ugly builds. No, I'm just kidding. Well, I mean, maybe ugly builds. I don't know. I think this build's all right so far. I'm probably not going to make it a whole lot bigger. I'm probably going to actually go AFK after this episode and let the snow fall and cover up everything. And then we should have a circle around this where the snow doesn't touch the ground. And that will add to the atmosphere a little bit. And then I'm going to add, should I add posts to this? Like, it kind of looks weird like this, I think. I think we definitely need posts. I think we can use fence, though, like I wanted to before. Let's get some more. I got stone walls. That's right. I made a ton of them. So I can do right there. And how far away do I need to be? I think that it will work plenty well if I go right there. And then just do that for all the corners. So yeah, let me know what you guys like specifically. It helps a lot, you know. Just numbers are hard to read sometimes, especially when I haven't been super consistent with my upload times and how often. But, you know, just trying to get a reading of it, figure out what's best for me. But that looks about like what I wanted. I like it. So the idea is that you'd come right here. We can get some coarse dirt and path blocks going. I have some coarse dirt on me. So let's just knock some out. Frame rates are going crazy because we're in the snapshot. Just knock away. I'm going to mix them with path blocks. So just like this. Pathways make the world go round. I think I've talked about this before, but if you just don't know what to do, add a pathway. It makes such a big difference. See, all of a sudden, this very boring ground, it's a lot better to look at. Because you can tell a lot of people would spend time right here looking at this thing and the safety of their walls. But I think that's going to add quite a bit to our... you don't call this a courtyard, do you? Someone told me, by the way, they reminded me. Game mode 3, I believe, spectator mode. I don't have to use creative anymore. I had totally forgotten that spectator mode was even a thing in Minecraft. But, you know, I've been going up to right about here to get a view of my stronghold here to see how I like it. And I do like it. That was like a glaring blank spot right there. And now I think if I add some more pathways from the gate to that fire pit to this building in the middle here, this like tiny little one with the bridge, and to some of these other pathways, I think connecting all those will make a big difference. It doesn't need to be cluttered by any means. Maybe some barrels. We can make up some barrels. I've talked about changing the texture of the trap doors so that we could, you know, make barrels out of them. I really don't like that they're transparent. It's really an ugly texture. But yeah, these are the main buildings, the main walls. This is more or less like the rough draft of how this entire build's gonna look. So next episode, I'm probably gonna be looking at finishing up the towers, or having them finished by next episode. Figuring out where I want some of these in-between buildings to go, the pathways, and then we might be done. We can maybe move on to the next part of the story, which, if you guys don't know, so the story is that, I repeat this all the time, but these orcs sent had a summoner send a stone golem to attack a farming town, and we came here to infiltrate, and there's a infiltration hole way back here. Right here. See, good hole. I couldn't even find it. Right here. Oh gosh, you can clip through the ground. Oh, that's bad. That's cheaty. That's not any better than creative, guys. That's horrible. not that I've been mining around here anyway. As you can see, everything is very, very dark. But we infiltrate this place to figure out, hey, why'd you send your dude to mess up our stuff? And we're going to find out, or we found out, that they don't have any food here. It's barren. Aren't there supposed to be polar bears, by the way? I have not seen any polar bears. Or are those in ice spikes? I roamed around the ice spikes, too, and I didn't see any. Anyways, they don't have any food, so they came to our farming town, and they're like, attack it. Get some food. So they want our farming town. So next step is probably going to be getting some help from a larger army. And where would a larger army be? A larger city. That's right. I'm thinking about doing a big imperial city. Just like the capital city around this. Because, you know that the Farmer Guild isn't governing anything. We got to have, like, a proper castle in this world, with a proper town, high population town. So that's, I'm thinking, going to be our next project. We got a little bit more work to do here, so I'm going to do the pathways, actually, before we finish up. I realized a few things while I was doing this. One, the snow's just going to cover up this path. Now, I don't know if snow covers path blocks. In fact, I don't even know if it's considered a full block, or if the snow covers it, does it convert it to a regular block? That's an interaction that I don't know. Now, Spartan Overdrive, another YouTube buddy, he had pointed out that I could put string up in the sky to stop snow from falling wherever I don't want to fall. So I could do that. Problem is, I don't have a spider farm. I could probably just go caving until I find one, find some mine shafts, and just farm away at string, because it'd probably take a while if I just killed spiders at night. But other than that, geez, I feel like I'm so framey right now. I'm not really sure why. Another thing that I was playing with that I want to do before we finish up in this area, snow drifts, stuff like that. Now, if you do something like this, make it all come from one direction. So, like, in most places, I think in most places, like, where I grew up, the wind always came from the northwest because we were near a jet stream. So I don't know if you're not near a jet stream, maybe the wind varies more. But where I was from, snow always built up on the northwest side of things, right? I think I'm getting that my directions right. So let's say that the snowdrifts only go this way. You're going to have a snowdrift over here, but you're not going to have it on this side of the wall because it's going to be blocked from the wind. Now, there will ideally be snow here off the path once I let it snow again, but it won't be collecting drifts. excuse me, noisy guy in your car outside. You're really cool, but can you stop? You could even do it on the roofs here. I think it could look pretty cool. Right now, it just kind of looks like fresh snowfall, but you can make it look like a more of a buildup with this effect. But other than that, we're almost done with this area. By the way, if you start hearing like a noise in the background, like a little bit of background noise, white noise, it's because I have the AC on. I'm not sure how the recording program handles a change in background noise. But hopefully it's not too bad. Anyways, yeah, this place is almost done. I'm excited to finish it up. So we got a beautiful view here. Thank you guys for watching. If you haven't, leave a like and subscribe, and I really appreciate it. Bye!